Hey there, the future superstar trader. Welcome to my channel. Today we're gonna learn about the basics of desktop versions of MetaTrader 4. You can start trading as soon as you finish this video. Guaranteed satisfaction. I will post the timestamp on the description box so you can skip the part you want to watch. Let's start by registering a demo account first, because desktop version do not supply demo account. I'll be using XM as example since their demo account does not require phone verification and is more direct. So on xm.com homepage, we will click the open a demo account. Get all the information field, not necessary re-information as it is a demo account. On the trading platform type here, select MT4 since you're using MetaTrader 4. For account type, both of them are at one standard lot size, anyone will do, but ultra low standard has cheaper spread. You might want to use that. Base currency, you can pick anyone. Leverage, the higher the better. As the higher leverage, the lesser fund your broker holds. The lower the leverage, the more funds your broker holds, yet you cannot trade more. Of course, it's up to you how to manage risk, just don't overtrade and you are safe. Investment amount, any amount you like. And create a random password, proceed and click open a demo account. You will soon receive an email address. After the validations of your email address, you will receive another email with your MT4 ID and server name. Now, we will need a MetaTrader 4, the trading software, to start trading, so proceed to download it. I'll be downloading on xm.com simply because their official website, metatrader4.com, pretty much fool you into downloading MetaTrader 5 for some reasons. So on their homepage, click the word platform and select MT4 for PC or MT4 for Mac. Desktop, right? Click download, open it and install it. A side note here, it doesn't really matter where did you download MetaTrader 4 software, as long as your broker supports it as a trading platform, you can use the existing one instead of downloading a new one. MetaTrader 4 and the numbers of servers, they all look the same, but wait! The email, yeah, that email, open it up and pick the selected server. Click existing trading account, copy the MT4 ID and the random password you have created earlier. Welcome to Forex Market, your trading journal starts here and I'm glad you're still incoming with me. Mail. Let's start on the left first. Here, you see a bunch of 6 character words, which they are a combination of 2 different currencies in 3 letters ISO country code. Do you know them? Don't tell me you never knew it and you're looking to trade Forex. These 2 little boxes here with the price codes are left the selling price and right is the buying price. Say the EURUSD, when it happened hearing someone say buy EURUSD, they meant buy euro and in exchange sell USD. And in the opposite, sell EURUSD meant sell euro buy USD. Try to keep this short and simple, hope you get some clue. If you right click on the boxes, you click the word spread, a box of exclamation marks showed up. Spreads, in simple words, the price differences between the buying and selling price. Market watch is an indication of when were these prices last updated. If you are seeing this number hangs, it's either weekends or you are disconnected. Again, if you right click on the boxes and click time, it shows you the latest updated times of these individual trading instruments. Got it? If not, rewind it. It's pretty useful stuff to learn. Now, right, you have 4 charts by default created by Metacos, their company, to give you these impressions of how complex was their software is. Ahaha, skip the trash talking. Unlike web and app versions, on desktop version, you will allow to open as many charts as possible as long as your computer can read whole. Opening multiple charts are mostly used to study different time frame of a currency pair or the correlation between this and that currency, or just open to test how great your PC were. Anyway, you can actually maximize, minimize, group, tie, side by side, close as you like. It works the same like how you did on your Windows operating system. Double click to maximize. Double click here to restore the previous setting. Right clicking here for more options like maximize, minimize tie or close it. Or you can use the leader icon here. Now let's focus on a single chart for now. Say now I want to study different currency pair, say EURUSD, left side click hold, drag EURUSD, chart. Next, the chart setting. By default, MetaTrader offers three types of price setting: bar, candlestick, and line. There are also much simpler and complex chart like Heihin Hashi and Renga, which could be installed through indicators. Depends on you, my recommendation is Heihin Hashi if you're a beginner and candlestick if you really want to learn technical analysis. We'll be using candlestick for now. Scrolling to the left is the historical pricing. Here is the latest price which can be seen here and here. Now we will want to see a bigger picture of what happened in the past few days, weeks, or even months. You are seeing M1, M5, M15, and H1, D1, W1, and MN, right? These M's are known as minutes. When you click M1, meaning each candlestick represents 1 minute. When you switch it to M5, meaning 5 minutes per candle. H1 as to 1 hour per candle, and so on. When you click this icon, the chart will automatically move to the latest candle when any new price was given. When you click this icon here, it creates a space or shift basically made for better view. You can adjust it by click and drag this little arrow here too. Now since I don't like the look of this chart, I prefer plain background with blue color as upward and red color as downward. I want to customize the chart. When you right click on the chart and click properties, this menu shows up. You're given three default themes here, but I want something else. I want something straightforward. I want red and blue. Here are a group of drawing tools. Click any one of them and you can add them to your chart. The purpose of these drawings are meant to predict the future possible price movement, which you have seen many traders does. I sometimes wonder, do they really works? There are even more hidden here on this insert button. You may want to learn playing around with it. Other than that, you can add or remove the drawing tools you want by right-clicking them and click Customize. Here is where you say welcome or goodbye to them. Depends how friendly you were, I mostly said goodbye to them. Now that your chart is a little messy, how about a little housekeeping? To remove all this drawing, you can double-click them, right-click and click Remove. Alternatively, right-click on the chart and click Object List, and select the drawings you want to remove. When you roam around any trading forum, you'd be very lucky if you never seen pictures like this. These boxes, these drawings are indicators used to predict price movement. Some indicator has their individual window, while some are attached directly to the price chart. To demonstrate it, say now we are looking to install an indicator to help us to predict the market's trend. In short, I want something to tell me if this is going up or down. On the navigator box on the left, we expand the box name indicators. Search for MACD, MACD, click and drag it to the chart. The parameter should be default here as to 12, 26, 9. Click OK and there you go. Then we want to add moving average to our chart. We repeat the same thing again. Click and drag. You may want to configure the setting here. You can play around with the parameters, say for example, changing the period to any amount like 200, which means moving average based on 200 days, or 1, which is the average of every single day. Play it around. Then the MA method to simple. Click OK, now we have a 200 SMA. This setting was used by many professional traders, and so you are a professional trader now. Since moving average are a popular tool, some traders are obsessed of placing them everywhere. Say now I want to attach a moving average to my existing indicator MACD, click and drag the moving average to MACD, expand the drop-down box beside Apply To, select First Indicators Data, click OK, and my obsession is satisfied. To remove them, just right-click and click Delete. Expert Advisor are also known as automatic trading robots. Scripts are written programs to customize your trading platform, say for example, change all existing orders, stop loss, close all trades, open 10 random trades, add some random drawings on the chart, and so on. We have the chart customized, we have the drawings and indicators deleted, now we want to start the trade. Upon sliding the symbol set here, I couldn't find the trading instruments I wanted to trade. I accidentally right-click on the symbols and a couple of options show up. Wow, right-click is sold, couldn't find a word to describe. There are four options here available, hide all, show all, and symbols. If you want to save trouble, you can click show all, and all trading instruments will show up. But this sort of saving trouble brings you trouble more. If it happens that you want to trade a trading instrument where an upcoming economy data will be published in 30 seconds, then it's like a racing game. You're like, oh my god, the time is ticking. Where's that? What was that again? I usually do the adding individual symbols and remove those that I will not and never trade, like this, click symbol, and customize according to your preferences. When you're done, let's start the trade. Double click on any symbol sets you would like to trade, or do the magical right click again if you want to be more secure in case you misclick the wrong one. You can also right click on the chart, hover your cursor to trading, and click new order. A message pops up asking if you want to activate the one click trading mode, meaning click this button here without asking for confirmation, your order is triggered. Let's try it out. Agree to terms and conditions, otherwise you can click OK. Click. You saw that? Even for closing a trade. I believe some of you prefer two-click trading mode instead of one, so do I. To disable it, click Tools, click Options, click Trade, untick one-click trading. Back to where we had stopped, double-click the symbol sets you want to trade, a trade order box pops up. The left graph here is the tick chart which updates every single bit of moves, can be seen here as well. This is the symbol size options. Volume is the amount of trading size, depends on the broker. Most accounts are registered under 100,000 unit per lot or one standard lot. Keep this number small if you don't want to risk big. Stop loss is trade close when the market price reaches the price you have set. Take profit is the same as well, but close in profit. Click on boxes beside the word type. You're given two options, which are market executions and pending orders. Market executions is where orders are placed at current market price, like this. Pending orders, where orders are not executed instantly, but until a certain price level you have set was met. You're seeing four fancy names here, buy limit, sell limit, buy stop, and sell stop. Let's make it short here. Say, if you want to buy at the lower spot, you use buy limit. If you want to sell at the higher spot, you use sell limit. Then, if you want to buy at the higher spot, which do you really want to buy at the higher spot? Anyway, you use buy stop. Then, if you want to sell at the lower spot, you use sell stop. This little box here is your ordering price. Let's try it. Order place. This is the price you've ordered, and this is the current market price. If you don't want this order, you want to cancel it, simply double click and close the order. Then, in case you, for some reason, I forgot to set the take profit for your existing order, double click on the SLTP area of the trades you've ordered, set it here. To close the trade, double-click anywhere aside the SLTP or simply right-click it. Then click the yellow close button. Been scripting for so long and I forgot to include this part. Balance, equity, margin, free margin and margin level. Balance should be your deposit, adding or deducting or close trade. Equity is real-time value of your account funds. Margin is the amount of funds held by a broker which altered by the leverage you have selected. The higher the leverage, the more you're allowed to trade. The lower the leverage, the lesser you're allowed to trade in short. Free margin is the amount of funds available after equity minusing the existing margin to determine how much free funds you have and if you are able to open more trades, since every trade requires margin. Margin level is the ratio between margin and free margin. In case if this reaches below 50%, you will get a margin call from your broker. All trade will be closed. There are also credit which not shown here, which represent bonus funds offered by a broker. And at the bottom here, we have exposure, which are how your funds were allocated. Account history, which is your trading records. News, which are news. Some broker don't update it at all. Alert is like an alarm, said you want to be notified when a certain currency symbol reaches a certain price level. This alert can be a simple sound to push notification to your phone. Mailbox are mostly welcome messages and will never be updated since. Market is where vendors, scriptwriters, programmers put their products into sales. Some are free though. You can download custom indicators made by them directly to your MetaTrader platform. Signals is where traders like you and me have their trading records exposed publicly. Then there are some random traders like you and me again got terrified by their trading results who want to copy this awesome superstar trader's trade, which possibly you. Depends on them, most charges a monthly subscriptions, but there are some who offer for free. Articles are articles published by members on MQL forum. Code base is like a junk pile. Good, bad, random indicators and script could be found here. To download it, use the magical right click. Expert is a log of expert advisors and indicators. Journal is a log of every action you have done on your MetaTrader software. And if it happened that you're experiencing a slow response to your server, you may click the little button here on the lower right. A list of servers shows up. MS stands for millisecond, which 1000 MS is 1 second. The lower the MS means a faster response rate. I think I've pretty much covered all the important parts of what you as a future superstar trader should know. This will be the end of the video. Yes, it's sad I have to go. Leave me a question on the comment section, like, share, and comment. Goodbye!